Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I am here with Dean and Heather, and they have a cart that they custom built themselves and have started vending. They're just finishing their first year. So, Dean and Heather, welcome, and thank you for being here and taking the time. I know you're tired, and I'll try to do this as quickly as possible, but I know you, and I love you because you're in Vendors United, and I've watched this progress, but so many people would be inspired and helped and by your story. So tell me, right from the get-go, how did you, what was the genesis of, I'm going to do hot dogs, I'm going to be a hot dog vendor?
Well, a lot of people keep telling me the only complaints I get about my cooking is I don't do enough of it. And I've catered for events up to 500 people. And a couple of years ago, we looked at starting a barbecue business, and things happened and life happened. And then we found Vendors United. We found, you know, your site, and we started talking about it. I'll let Heather go into, she was not thrilled at first. Hot dogs was not what it once she was really looking at. But she liked the idea of lemonade. So we started thinking, okay, we could, you know, and we started hearing more and more that, you know, people doing hot dogs were also doing lemonade. It was a great add-on. It's like, well, we could do that together. And it gives us something to do together. So we're working this as a business together. As I said, I run the grill and the steam table. She runs the lemonade side of the cart. And I'm going to send you pictures so you can put it up for everybody to see. It's a big cart, and it does everything we want, and designed to, we want to cater. We can cater and cook just about anything. It's got a 36-inch flat top and a double steam table, and a 7-foot stainless counter down one side where she does drinks and everything.
Wow.
But it's the impetus for hot dogs was finding your site, and saying, you know, I saw one of your videos. You can build your own, you know. And I said, well, yeah, I can. I can weld, and I can build just about anything. I'll send you some pictures of other stuff I've made. And we started talking about it, and I bought your course and started designing it. And about 6 months, and in between doing a lot of stuff, redesigning it, coming up with a design, and did everything we wanted to do in the way we wanted to do. And finally, we just said, you know what? We finally got a design that I liked and I thought would work for us, and we started building it. And about 500 man hours into that, after, you know, her and I out there sweating buckets, and she was right there with me the whole time. So I'd say 500 man hours, that's 500 hours of our time. Right. I don't, you know, it was about 2 months.
About 2 months.
Well, it sounds like a limousine of a cart. I guess once you said, okay, I'm going to do this, and you design your cart, and you go through the pains of building a custom cart, how do you pick your menu? What was your hurdles from going from, hey, I now am a cart owner? How do you go from there to on the street, and how did you come up with that stuff?
While we were building it, we ordered a smasher, and we started playing with making lemonade. We went into the local store and bought a pack of every hot dog they had. And you've said this, you know, go find out what they sell in the store. And we looked at everything that sold, and we started visiting other carts in the area and seeing what they were selling. And we just sat there and played with cooking hot dogs different ways and what could we do with them and with what we had on the cart. And we came up with a menu that I liked. And again, I've been cooking forever. I've got probably 20 or 30 of my own recipes that I've built over time. I've got a few sauce recipes. I have a peanut butter based wing sauce. I guess my thinking was there's nothing wrong with a boiled hot dog, but it's a boiled hot dog. And that's because I wanted to get the flat top, and I went over to the health district and they said, yeah, you can put that on there. So I did. I put a 36-inch Blackstone on, and we use a New England style bun and toast them and do a little bit more than just boiling the hot dog and putting on a raw bun.
Right.
And we think that's part of what sets us apart. And, you know, I say this a lot. It's the little things that make a difference, because it's a hot dog. Anybody can make a hot dog. But I've had many people go, you know what, and they ask us, what are you serving for hot dogs? They're Muckies. They're a local New England, actually just this area of New England specialty. They're made local.
What are they called?
Muckies.
Muckies. Okay.
Yeah. I'll send you a logo for them too, so you can put it up. So yeah. People can get them. But it's a local favorite. And when people find out that's what we have, that actually is a decision maker sometimes whether they buy from us. It's a local, and it's a good dog. But I've had other people go, you know, mine don't come out this good at home. And I said, well... we take extra care.
Right.
But
right.
From building the cart, I mean, going, I walked into the health department with my diagrams and a printout for every piece of equipment I was putting on it. And the guy was like, wow, this is, you got everything you need here. This looks perfect. Go build it. So I did, and then got it inspected. And, the girl come out and inspected it, and she was like, this is the bougiest hot dog cart I've ever seen. I was like, all right, I win. You know, I, that's what I'm thinking, bougie. Okay.
So, I like that.
And then, you know, we picked a day, and it was the first weekend in September last year. And we loaded up
weekend.
Yeah, Labor Day weekend. We loaded up the cart and the back of our SUV and took everything and more food than we, you know, because we're going to take over the world and we're going to sell 400 people today. And we did it. We took it with us. We didn't sell 400 people. but we did okay. I mean, and we've grown. I that first day was not the lowest day we've ever had, but it wasn't the highest either. But it we learned a lot. And the first month, we learned a ton. Because there's right. No substitute for experience. You just get out there and do it. And that's what the whole thing was like. We didn't set up in a yard and try it out. We didn't. I don't think we even cooked anything on it before we set up. I lit the steam table and timed how long it took the water to boil.
That was it.
I took pictures
of that too.
Yeah, I wanted to know how long it took to bring the water up to steam and water up to boil. And I had that timed out and playing with the burners and all that stuff. But then we just hooked up and went. And I work a day job, plus I work at Lowe's at night. And that's why we got in front of Lowe's, because I actually told a couple of people in the store what I was doing. They went to the store manager, like four people went to the store manager. Hey, did you know Dean's doing this? And they were like, okay, great. Let us know when you're ready to set up. And you can have any spot you want. I was like, all right. They've supported me unbelievably through this. I think our first day, I'd have to look at the numbers, but I think we sold more to employees. I know one employee came out and got six lemonades that day.
Yeah.
That's good. That's great.
Yeah, so
I love that you took both things on. I mean, I never recommend it, but you already had experience in doing catering events and stuff. So you knew what it was going to be like hectic wise trying to do hot dogs and lemonade at the same time and being new, brand new. So so the Lowe's is where you're vending now, for the most part.
On the weekends, we're right in front of the Lowe's Pro exit, the first two parking spots right out front of the door. And during the week, Heather and my son Carter set up in the same plaza, but it's out near the entrance. It's in the bank parking lot because Lowe's, the manager, doesn't want to deal with corporate. And if we're set up during the week, corporate shows up, they'll give him a hard time. So he's like, just here on the weekends. Like, fine, I'll find another spot. And Saturdays has been our when it's not raining, we can be there. It's our best day there. And we've started... We just started talking to the bank about, hey,
Just on a whim, I said, we have a hot dog cart and whatnot, and she perked right up, and we said, we were looking for other places to go, and she said, you guys can park out here anytime you want. We talked about when the busiest times were and all of that, and they were thrilled. They had no problem. We parked, all the way over as far away from their building so that we didn't impede any traffic in and out of the bank, and they don't have any problem with us being there. They
that's
love it.
And that's fantastic.
Yeah, you turn in at the lights, and that's we're right across the grass strip in their parking lot from the entrance, the plaza entrance, or one of the plaza entrances. So it makes us very visible.
Nice.
So it's,
nice.
And it's a busy road. But
so what is the biggest thing you've seen in your first 10 months as a challenge that you would do differently, or the biggest headache? You can share either one. And then I'd also like to ask you both, where do you see yourself in the future? What's your plans going forward? What's your goals?
All right, so the biggest headache, I would say, is understanding social media and how to use it correctly. We still struggle with that, trying to get engagement. That just
I work mostly on in Facebook. Every now and then I put things in for Instagram. I'm a little better versed at Facebook than I am the other two. I've been trying TikTok. Not going to give up with it, but I'm definitely not going to say that I'm good at it. So, what favorite drinks, favorite toppings for hot dogs. I found something that puts up every day for what day of the year, what is being celebrated each day of the year. Brownie locks. And so I go through and look for those. And if I don't find something that I think I can get anyone to engage with, I've had battles with people as far as toppings or food or whatever, but it's been good natured stuff. It hasn't been anything like
negative, right?
Nothing negative.
Right.
But that's been the biggest thing is trying to get out that we're here.
I think, and the other challenge is we haven't started doing events yet. Well, we have our first event coming up. There's a concert series on the downtown that we're Park and Rex is putting on. Mm-hmm. We've got next Friday our first concert. We went to the one last week, and that was
a little disappointing.
There was all of about 12 people there, and it was supposed to rain, so they moved it inside. I'm hoping that's just because it was not a a real draw, but the only people that were there were the people from the senior center around the corner. So we're hoping that, the group that's playing next week is going to be a bigger draw. But if it's not, it gets us in with the Park and Recs, and we've already started talking to them about doing some of their games and stuff like that.
Right.
So it's a door opener for us, and we're not paying anything to be there except for a percentage. We made a group for 10% of our growth of our sales. So it's not like we're paying $200 to be there and there's no one showed up. So
right.
And it's on a Friday. We've ended on Saturday, so I mean it's not like we're gonna lose any product either. We kept everything frozen. So We'll roll with the punches and see what happens there. But I think that's our other challenge is finding events, finding things that.
Well, we talk with all of our customers. I mean, you know, just all it is being neighborly. I know we talked about my biggest challenge originally is I didn't want to do it. I did not want to do it. And I was very vocal and I was very much up front with him the first weekend that we went. It was a lot of work, but it was a lot of fun and engaging with our customers kind of changed my mind as far as that.
I get that. Yep. That's the fun part.
But talking with people and just kind of, you know, things that are going on with their day. I've spilled several drinks in 10 months in front of customers. It's always been entertaining to them. Not so much to me, but just kind of, you know, letting people know that you're human, that, you know, you're not trying to perfect about all of this stuff. But while we're talking about those things, we've been making contacts with other vendors, with some of the officials in the town, people who do events. I mean, the more people that we talk to, the more engaged.
Yeah.
You know, there are more opportunities that come
yeah,
up.
Definitely. I love it. So going forward, is your goal to do less street or less at a place, you know, like Lowe's, and more events? And try to, you know, hit the ball out of the park at the events and then, you know, have fun with the street stuff?
I think the street vending will probably go down to one day a week. And we're looking more at doing events and catering and private events, you know, so employee appreciation or employee cookout or just
nice.
You know,
getting into with the schools,
yeah.
With the athletics, any of the organizations basically in town. We have a charity that we're working with now that they train dogs for the disabled
service dogs,
excuse me. So,
I think and ultimately we want to grow this. We talked about this in the beginning. Says I want to get this to the point where we've got a couple of carts out there. I know you talk about having 21 and it was a mistake and I'm listening to that, but my first thought was, well, I'd like to have 21 carts out there, but then you look at what's entailed in doing that and maybe I wouldn't. But the idea is to maybe go out and franchise this, maybe go out and expand into other areas because we really want to build this into something that's a retirement for us. That's if we can either sell it off or we can make enough money to put away so that that's not an issue. Even if it's just sell at one point, just selling off all the carts and all the locations and, you know, letting people run with what they want. So that's kind of our ultimate goal is to take this into a retirement situation.
Love it. Love it. And also, cut back on or eventually be done with the JOB, the just over broke stuff, the job stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Well, so my last question is, what would you tell a brand new person that's thinking, considering this business with the experience you have up to now and the hard work that it took to get to here, what would you tell them about the business that would be the best information to help them make a decision whether this is right for them?
Do it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Do it.
You know, I
don't overthink it.
I would say research because I watched everything I could find with you in it. So you can't research it too much, I don't think, but you've got to get to the point where it's time, like I said, just time to do it. So I hate to say you can't research too much, but once you start going over the same things over and over, you've looked at everything and you've got all the information, just make the decision. And if you like to talk to people and you like cooking, there's no better. Because you work in a restaurant, you're back in the kitchen, you don't talk to people. My kitchen's out there on the counter, you know. So I'm cooking, but I'm talking to everybody. I enjoy the people. So it is a lot of fun to be out there, and we have a good time, even when it's, you know, 100 degrees out and my thermometer just goes high, because it's all, and then I take the digital, the infrared, and look at the concrete that's, you know, over 130 degrees the blacktop is. Those are rough days. I go through a lot of these.
I bet.
You know, we keep after each other, make sure we're all three staying hydrated, and no one's, you know.
Good for y'all.
So, passing out. But yeah, I would say the best advice I could give anybody is do a little bit of research, plan out what you want to do, and just jump in. And don't be afraid to make mistakes, because we made a ton of them. You can't see it, but I'm missing a little bit of eyebrows here because I had a little bit of backfire on my steam table the other day and burnt part of the tent, lost the hair on my arms, and curled my eyebrows. So
and burned his knees.
Oh, yeah, the flame came out the front, burned my knees, because I was in shorts for once in that day. So, don't be afraid of mistakes. Just learn from them. So, Heather and Carter were coming home one day when they were vending. And you want to tell them what happened?
Oh, the trailer fell off the truck.
Oh.
We thought we had it. We had it on... you know, on the ball, long day. I had been talking to a whole bunch of people. We were trying to get back, and we had somewhere else that we needed to be.
Come get me.
I had to get, yes, I was trying. And I thought I had everything all squared away and went to, we were sitting at a stop sign, getting ready to turn, and my son screamed, "Stop!" Slammed on the brakes and watched the cart go pink, hit the ground. Yeah. That was exciting, and thankfully we had a couple of good Samaritans stop and help us. Just do it, and don't take yourself too seriously, because you're going to do some really stupid things, and it's going to be public. And if you can't laugh at yourself, cry in public. No, cry in private, but laugh in public. I'm very good about making sure now that the hitch. It's properly put together.
Don't take yourself too seriously. Go out, make some mistakes, and try to learn from other people's mistakes. So you don't make some of the big ones. But just do it and have fun with it.
That's the biggest thing I've heard during Vendors United is the ability to avoid a lot of those learning curves. I want to thank both of you for coming on.